Hello and welcome to my channel. I am so glad that you decided to come by and hang out with me today. If you've never been here before, I like to call myself the Humble Bumble, and I am pollinating the world with the good news of the gospel through song, and I like to do that on Mondays. And then on Fridays, I come out with what I call a potluck video, whatever God lays on my heart. I really don't know what it's going to be, but I really think you should go and check out my movie from last week. It's a spiritual buffet kind of a thing. I called it The American Religion and a Counterfeit Gospel. And I feel like the word counterfeit, it really fits what I'm trying to go with here. Because what would seem to be godly, what has the presence of, you know, what would be godliness, how they use the name of Jesus and throw it around like a rag doll and it has no meaning. But nevertheless, they use the name of Jesus, and because of that, people are absolutely confused because they have a soft spot in their heart for Jesus. And too much today, people go off this feeling that they have, and they seem to rely on their hearts, but it says in the Bible that we are not to, you know, trust our hearts because they're deceitful, they're wicked and cruel above all things. They cannot be trusted. And so we as human beings, you know, we go by feelings way too much, but we ought to teach ourselves not to. And so today's video, I'm actually trying to tell you a little bit about me, because what better way to build a family than to actually, you know, confide in each other, tell each other things. No, I'm not going to go into anything too deep, but since this is a music channel, I thought it would be very appropriate if I talked a little bit about some of my musical background, but not the things that I've done per se, but who I used to be influenced by. Just, I was crazy about the Beatles. Because my daddy also come from that hippie generation, he held on to, unfortunately, the Beatles. And because they captivated me so much, I also loved the Beatles. My twin sister didn't, but I did. And for years, I loved them. I used to say that I liked them from their earlier days. You know, I want to hold your hand and that type of stuff. But I would definitely say that I would have to be lying if I am not more captivated, or was more captivated, with the Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. I sadly know just about every single word of that album because I loved it. I used to listen to it in my car all the time, constantly drilling my head with these satanic songs. Now, I had no idea that the Beatles were satanic. And I just loved them for their music. I listened to them for whatever reason. It was just, I was crazy about the Beatles, but I did not know the Beatles' background. And this is why it is so important for us to, you know, really study up on it, on who we're listening to, on who we allow into our hearts, because music goes straight into the soul and it influences us. It really does. And we're living in a generation today where that is so extremely dangerous. So, because I just want to state some facts, I am not here to blow a bunch of smoke up your nose or in your ears. I am only here to tell you facts and the truth, and I want you to decide these things for yourself. But I will never forget that when my mom and my dad was still alive, I was living in Knoxville for 3 years. And when I was living there, my mom and my dad came to visit me. And when they went to my room, I had so much Beatles stuff on my walls, from posters to little pictures to this huge Abbey Road poster that was just over my closet. I had some very interesting things, but that is straight up idolatry, guys, because anything that you put before God is idolizing, period. That becomes your God, and I didn't know it, but that had become my God, and I am telling you right now, if I knew that, I would have run away from it then, because it wasn't worth it to me even then. I would have given it up if I had known. But my dad walked over to my Lonely Hearts Club poster, and he pointed out the fact that Aleister Crowley was in that picture or poster. And if you don't know who Aleister Crowley is, you really should, because he has a huge influence on music today. And we're going to get into that probably Friday, because I'm feeling really led to do a video on Aleister Crowley, also Anton LaVey. He was the one who wrote the Satanic Bible, and he was very much inspired by Aleister Crowley's work that he had done beforehand. And we're also going to go over a lady named, and I know that I'm getting this wrong, but it's Abrima Brockovich, I think is her name. She is probably a high priestess, and she is highly influential in the music industry today. And also, I was a little bit shocked because I was watching YouTube the other day and noticed that a Gucci Bloom, like a perfume commercial, it came up and I was watching it. I saw this lady, Abrina, in the background, and I'm like, what? I know what she does. I know what she stands for. Holy cow. What is she doing? So I went to YouTube and I actually looked up the full length version of the Gucci Bloom commercial. Let me tell you, she is actually doing a satanic ritual in this commercial. If you're not educated and stuff, you probably wouldn't be able to tell. But believe me, I am absolutely able to tell. She is putting her hands up, doing some kind of spiritual satanic ritual in this Gucci Bloom commercial. So I am here to tell you that I will not own anything Gucci. Even if I desired it before, I will not have it. But something Abrima Brockovich does is loves Lady Gaga. Even though I love the Beatles, I also loved Lady Gaga. This was back right before I found the Lord. I found him when I was 33 years old. You know what? I'm going to take that back. He found me. I just followed him. That's all I did. But I loved Lady Gaga. I did not know anything about Lady Gaga's background. I just listened to her music, guys. That's all I did. So I didn't know about all the super crazy stuff that she was doing. I had heard a little bit about it here and there. Never been to a concert. I just loved her music. And so I just could not imagine going a day without listening to something inspirational from Lady Gaga, because she was such a pick-me-up. The music was so motivational. I just absolutely loved, you know, Lady Gaga. But then after I got saved, God burdened me with it. You know what? I can remember I was getting ready to work out and I was on a treadmill. And I remember when I would work out, I absolutely loved to listen to Lady Gaga because, man, I could break out, you know, of sweat, really work hard because her music was so, it was just so upbeat. But the fact is, God said that I needed to look into her. I had never watched a video. Finally, I'm looking up Poker Face. I'm looking up Alejandro. There's symbolism in these things. Something is very wrong. And then she comes out with a video about I Love Judas Baby. At that point, I had already given up on her. But wow, that was really deep. And I do believe that I did hear something about it was so sexual, that movie. Or that video. I remember that I did hear that video was so sexual. So that is just a big red flag. No, I cannot listen to someone who completely contradicts the God that I serve. She does. And guess what, guys? Lady Gaga says that she's a Christian. She's a Christian. Mm-hmm. That's what she said. And please tell me that you are not going to be going out and buying her albums and that you're going to believe that trash. Lady Gaga is not a Christian. She is a counterfeit Christian at best. And I can't even say that she's counterfeit because she is a knockoff. Lady Gaga is not even counterfeit. She is just a Walmart special knockoff Christian, I think. And I'm not trying to be mean, but I'm saying that's how knockoff Lady Gaga is when it comes to Christianity. In today's video, I'm going to do something a little different. Before I sing a song, I'm actually going to show you some videos about the Beatles and about Lady Gaga. And if you did not know their satanic background and why I stopped listening to them and how it burdened my soul, because it says in the Bible that we're not supposed to put anything wicked before our eyes. The eyes are the window to the soul, and the ears, it's just going to pour right into your heart, and music is going to influence who you are. It's kind of like they say, You are what you eat. You know, if you eat McDonald's, then you're gonna look like McDonald's. If you listen to Lil Wayne or you listen to Marilyn Manson, then you're gonna look like that. And I don't want to look like that. I want to look like a Christian. So I'm gonna show you why Lady Gaga is not a Christian and who the Beatles really were. And I'm gonna see you guys in just a little bit and we're gonna sing a song.
In 1964, rock's most popular group of all time came singing, "I Want to Hold Your Hand." And after the world's youth gave their hand to them, they took them on a journey into drugs, permissive sex, Eastern mysticism, and Satanism. Yoko Ono said that the Beatles were not aware of all that was coming through them. She said they were like four mediums at a seance who had gathered together, and a spirit appeared and channeled through them. John Lennon couldn't have made it any clearer when speaking of the Beatles' success and stating, quote, "I sold my soul to the devil." In his book, Spaniard in the Works, John Lennon portrayed Jesus Christ as a, quote, "garlic-eating, stinking, little, yellow, greasy, fascist, blank, Catholic Spaniard," end quote. When Lennon tried to defend his boasting that he was more popular than Jesus, he stated,
"I think as Beatles as those other Beatles, like other people say, I just said they are having more influence on kids and things than anything else, including Jesus."
I swear to Lucifer.
Believe it or not, more of Lady Gaga's devil worship is clearly manifested in her song Judas, where she literally sings about her love for Judas Iscariot, the apostle who fell from grace and betrayed the Lord Jesus Christ with a kiss and handed him over to be tortured and crucified before he himself committed suicide. King without a crown. It further states, "In the most biblical sense, I am beyond repentance." End quote.
In the most biblical sense, I am beyond repentance.
I wandered so aimless, life filled with sin. I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more in darkness, no more in night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow in sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Just like the blind man, I wandered along. Worries and fears I claim for my own. Then like the blind man that God gave back his sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more in darkness, no more in night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow in sight. Saying, praise the Lord, I saw the light. All right, thank you so much for sticking with me. I hope that somebody out there really does grow for God today, that somebody learned something. Maybe I answered a question for somebody, helped them along the way, helped me to build a family. I'm giving a little piece of myself to you, and I hope that in return you guys will just subscribe to my channel, help me to pollinate the world with the good news of the gospel through song. And I just want to tell each and every one of you how much I love you for supporting me, for just, you know, loving God. You know, let's love each other and let's just support each other and let's help each other to walk this narrow road that we happen to be walking. I hope that you have a beautiful and blessed day.